There's no doubt about it. Aussies love getting out on the water. And with thousands of kilometres of coastline, not to mention rivers and lakes, there's plenty of places to drop anchor. But for some would-be boaties, just getting into the water can be enough of a challenge.
Have a look at this bloke. He's got no idea. How about I give him a bit of a hand?
As a rule, I find that people appreciate being told they aren't good at something. And I'm just the man to do it.
Just get over there out of harm's way.
Good, time, mate, to teach this landlubber a valuable lesson.
Here's the trick. Too much travel in the right-hand mirror, it's right-hand down. Too much travel in the left-hand mirror, it's left-hand down. OK, let's just straighten her up, shall we? Right-hand down, right-hand down. OK, left-hand down, left-hand down. Going to go forward again. You've been doing it as long as I have. It's not that hard.
Don't stop! Whoa!
Shit. Shit. Oh, God, dear. She just...
Situations such as this are a valuable reminder to us all of the need to be prepared.
Where are you?
No matter what the situation, things can go wrong.
Two knocks for yes, one knock for no. OK, maybe push up with your feet. Just go, like, give it a big push and I'll go at the same time. No? One, two, three, push. Yeah, OK. Start digging. G'day, how are you? Yeah, Russell Coight. Yeah, here are your thongs. Put those on. Anyway, I'll just go get a winch.
But I couldn't stick around to be thanked. I had a job to get. This is Eubinga Downs, a sheep and cattle station owned by my old mates, Mick and Bernie Agosta. Mick had called wanting some help with a problem around the house. And being in the district, I was naturally happy to oblige.
Places look great.
Yeah.
But you've got a bit of a problem with rabbits.
Yeah, that's right.
The little buggers are eating everything.
What do you try to get rid of them?
I try trapping them.
Trapping them.
Baiting them.
Baiting them. 1080?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll tell you one thing about rabbits. They breed like rabbits.
But this was no laughing matter. They needed help, and I was the man for the job.
You put the kettle on,
yep.
And maybe a bit of cake would be nice, and it won't take too long. See you in a minute.
Sounds great.
That'd be great.
See ya.
They might seem like the perfect pet, but rabbits are a serious problem for those in the bush. These pesky predators were first introduced into Australia in 1859 by this bloke, Thomas Austin. And it didn't take long for the promiscuous pair to start doing what came natural. Since then, they've been an environmental disaster, digging up valuable land, destroying precious plant life, and forcing out important native species. Time to fight back. Step one is to identify and then dig in as many burrows as you can find. This will help seal up the warren in preparation for stage two, high pressure liquid petroleum gas, pumped directly into the ground.
What I'm doing here is fixing the problem at the source. Underneath me is a very big rabbit warren. If we get rid of that, the rabbits will move on to greener pastures.
With the last of the holes safely sealed, it was time to get serious.
Okay, you guys can get right back. This area is hot. Keep going, keep going.
LPG is highly combustible, and even though the detonation would take place safely below ground, I didn't want to be taking any chances.
And it's bye-bye, bunny. Hi. What happened was you had some burrows underneath the house that you didn't tell me about. I won't hang around for a cup of tea or a piece of cake.
All Aussie Adventures, time to hit the road. Looks like some overnight storms had brought down a tree across the track. And I soon discovered I wasn't the only one going nowhere fast. This farmer was clearly in need of a helping hand.
G'day.
G'day.
Russell Coight.
John.
It's a doozy. I can see what's happened. She's come down overnight. You've come down here, tried to get around and got yourself bogged. I think this needs a heavy artillery.
Okay.
Stay here. I'll be back in a minute.
Right.
And by heavy artillery, I meant this. 6.5 tonnes of hydraulic heavy haulage borrowed from a nearby farm.
John, I'll get you to move right out of the way, mate.
Right.
Thank you.
Luckily, I've had a bit of experience with earth-moving machinery, and I knew just how to shift that lock. Guess you could call it muscle over matter. One. Two. Three. Station run by my old mate Mez Ryan, and she sure was glad to see me.
You rang about a problem?
Huh?
Rang about the boar?
Oh, the boar,
yeah, rang about the boar, need me to check how
she's
going.
Would you mind checking the boar?
Okay, well, why don't you put the kettle on, make a cup of tea, and I'll go get some stuff out of the car.
No worries, okay.
Turned out Mez was having trouble with her waterworks, a slow flowing boar. It might not sound like much, but boars are the lifeblood of a farm. Only it's not blood they pump, it's water. And without water, the stock could easily die. Time to identify the problem. During dry periods, groundwater levels can easily drop. So my first step was to ascertain just how deep the water was sitting.
I'm gonna measure the depth using this. It's a plumb line. Weight on one end and measurement all the way along. We drop it down. When it hits the water, we know how much water we're dealing with. Pretty straightforward, but you do have to know what you're doing. And down she goes. If you want to keep a property like this green, you need to have your balls working properly. Chicken got caught in the tape and it's gone. Oh, shit. Shit. It's dead. Ceases to amaze me the number of people who head out for a day on the water and they don't remember to check the basics. Engine, fuel, life jackets, flares, safety, equipment. You've got to be sure everything is ready to go or don't even think about heading off. I'm going to check my equipment one more time. Looking good. Let's go.
It's one thing to cruise up some slow-flowing local river, but head out on one of our outback waterways and you encounter a whole new type of danger. Yep, I'm talking crocs. Saltwater crocodiles, as their name implies, are crocodiles. And you find them just about everywhere up north. Whether in a boat or walking along the bank, you've got to be on your guard. That said, not every animal that lives around here is necessarily a croc.
Just found something I'd like to show you. These are animal tracks. Now, a lot of people mistake these tracks for a crocodile, but I can guarantee you these are the tracks of a turtle. Now, up there, there'd be a nest with some eggs in it, and the mother's come down here, gone out to get some food. Crocodile track is a lot different to that. Come down here and I'll show you the difference. So what you've got with a crocodile track is you've got a stronger drag point at the start. So that's a strong drag point that you can see the head of the crocodile. Then you see the footprints down there, and you'll see a strong drag point this way. This is obviously going out this way, and that's a turtle, and that is a crocodile. That's a...
All Aussie Adventures, time to hit the road. This is harvest time, with hundreds of hectares of paddock waiting to be cut, sorted, and stacked. It's a big job, but luckily these days we've got technology on our side.
Believe it or not, I'm driving that tractor from this app in here. And if you don't believe me, I'm gonna make it stop.
They don't call us the smart country for nothing.
How good is that? I'll make it start again. Absolutely incredible. Here, satellite, out of the tractor. I'm gonna make it swing around now. A little steering wheel here, little accelerator, little brake. Okay, now I'm gonna bring it back to me.
Yep, in the right hands, technology is pretty amazing stuff.
And stop. Incredible, isn't it? With this app and that tractor right there, I can take all those hay bales and put them into a truck.
Jump the boat! Push stop on the boat!
With that job taken care of, it was time to get stuck into another...